Welcome to 5 Points Blues presentation of Back to the Basics. Everything you wanted to know about Cowboys football, but were too afraid to ask. Here are your hosts, Nikki Harrison and Christy Scales.
Hello, happy Friday. It's Back to the Basics, everything you wanted to know about Cowboys football, but were too afraid to ask. I'm Nikki Harrison, here with Christy Scales, and this is our much-anticipated Oscars pre-show with Kelly Flinglass. Thank you for joining us.
Yes, I'm so excited. Yes,
and
yes.
Since Kelly has taken the time to come do this, we are literally rolling out the red carpet.
Yes.
No, this is literally, this is not from the Academy Awards, but this is from the Cannes Film Festival in the south of France.
It's
from
so cool.
2000.
Got it.
So this was tread upon by Catherine Deneuve and Bjork and Juliette Binoche. And
thank you, Kent. Yes.
Yeah. So, well, I just happened to be in Cannes the week after the film festival.
That's
and so
cool.
We were walking by the theater where they have it, and the film festival every year. And they were literally rolling up the red carpet, as in to take it away. And there
Did
were
you
some
pilfer
strands,
some pieces of
well, pilfer. You know, you may say pilfer. I will say saving the earth by keeping it from
recycling
going into a landfill. So it's literally red carpet from the film festival.
Doing good.
So special occasion today, 19
like
years
that.
Later. But that was the film
That's
festival.
That's awesome.
Do you remember Bjork? She's from Iceland. She's the singer. And she's the one
who
wore
the
swan.
She's
the one that wore the swan dress to the Academy Awards in 2001.
Yes.
And it's for a song that she did in the film Dancer in the Dark, where she actually won Best Actress at this film festival.
Oh, that's cool.
So. Now, this isn't as cherry red as I would have thought. Is this faded with time, or do they lean?
It's been stuck in a scrapbook for years.
Oh, so. Christy, this is priceless.
That's awesome.
So I just thought it'd be kind of fun to roll out a red carpet for today. But we've got predictions.
Yes, we do.
We have some movie trivia.
Mm-hmm.
So we have a lot to cover.
Yeah, we do. What do we want to start with? Our
well,
predictions.
Speaking of cover,
what do we want to start with?
I want to start with my prop. Because
okay.
I'm campaigning for Freddie Mercury. I am living, breathing Bohemian Rhapsody to such an extent that it's an obsession. And so I am dressed like Freddie Mercury in Live Aid and Rami. But
well,
I can't read with
these. Well, I think you have a shot because he's been doing really, really well this award season.
I'll jump on that soapbox when we get there. But yes.
that is fantastic. Well, let's start with Best Picture then.
Okay.
We're
going to
go through the main categories, and each of us will give our picks, and our producer today, Kent, is going to chime in as well because we want his picks too, so we have the male perspective.
Mm-hmm.
But Best Picture, go ahead with the nominees there.
I will. Black Panther, BlacKkKlansman, Bohemian Rhapsody, The Favorite, Green Book, Roma, A Star Is Born, and Vice. There's a lot.
Okay. Kelly, I'm going to go out on a limb and say that you're kind of leaning towards Bohemian Rhapsody in this category, or are you?
In this category, I'm not. I would. I'd give Bohemian Rhapsody every trophy I had, but there, I don't think the Academy's going to.
Really?
Okay. No. So let's do what we would pick personally, and then what we think is going to win. So.
I think what's going to win is Roma, because it has been winning everything. It's very... it's artistic. It's
very artistic.
Cinematography is black and white. And if you really get into it and you watch the details, it's all about a housekeeper in Mexico. And she's kind of caged. And if you watch, you'll see this bird in a cage that's in the set the whole time. Mm-hmm. There's all these little hints.
And the airplane flying across all the time. I agree. I thought it was really good.
I think, I mean, it took the Golden Globe.
It did.
Critics' Choice, the director as well. I personally kind of didn't jive with it. I got a little bored. Mm-hmm. I have a hard time kind of reading.
It's hard to follow.
It's deliberate. Mm-hmm. It's very deliberate.
Yeah.
By the way, you don't have to go to the movie house, to the theater to watch this. It's on Netflix. You can stream it.
That's right.
Oh,
Netflix.
Yes.
So I watched it at home.
Me too,
so
which
maybe
was cool.
It was cool, but you know, maybe in the theater, you know, on the bigger screen. But it's a very deliberate pace.
Mm-hmm. I would agree. Thank you, Kent. Are you he was just showing highlights from the film.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So I think Hollywood
I'm gonna mark
is
you
going
down.
To pick Roma, but my personal favorite movie of this season, and honestly, I loved A Star Is Born. Mm-hmm. Now, I'm going to go, since I've seen it five times now, okay. I'm going to go ahead and say, for whatever reasons, I was most entertained and moved and educated on Bohemian Rhapsody.
Okay.
Okay.
That's a favorite. That's
your favorite, but you believe
Roma. But your prediction is Roma.
Hesitantly, yes. Okay. Yes.
Nikki.
I have to go next.
And by the way, we've all seen most of the, I've seen. Mm-hmm.
I've seen Black Panther, Black Klansman, Roma, and The Star Is Born.
I've seen half a Black Panther. That's hard to say.
It is.
Black Klansman's kind of interesting.
That's a great film.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And
the,
I saw Vice.
The star of that, by the way, John David Washington, has come out to training camp a few times with his dad, Denzel, out to Cowboys training camp in Oxnard. So, and really nice guy.
It's a cool film.
It's very good. And if you close your eyes and just listen to him speak, he sounds so much like Denzel.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's uncanny, really.
Yeah. I'm sorry, the other ones that you've seen, let's see.
And I only could watch. And I haven't seen The Favorite, but
I loved it.
Either.
Yes, that's actually my favorite. Okay. Of all of them. I've seen all of them, and my favorite is, well, actually, the one that was was entertained the most are Bohemian Rhapsody and A Star Is Born.
Okay.
But I'm not saying it's the best film. My favorite is The Favorite.
That's what
I would pick. But I think it's going to be Roma as well.
You think
I predict Roma to win.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But if I had my choice, I would choose The Favorite. And a couple of notes on that film when we get to the actress category.
Okay.
Okay, Kelly?
Nikki. Yes.
I'm sorry, Nikki.
I'm okay.
Looking at Nikki.
I'll take Kelly.
Yeah, I'll take Nikki.
Okay.
I'm going to go out on a limb, even though I haven't seen it yet. I have heard it is fabulous, and that's The Favorite. I'm going to go with The Favorite. That's my prediction.
To win? Oh, my goodness.
There's always an upset.
Wow. Okay.
So.
Okay, Kent. But which one would you choose personally?
Which one would I choose personally?
Or do you agree with the Academy? It's nice when we can.
Yes. Well, I still want to see Vice, but I was entertained by Black Klansman. It was very, very entertaining and interesting.
It was.
Okay.
You know, so.
Okay. Kent.
Yes.
What's your prediction?
My favorite movie of the year that's nominated is probably Black Klansman. That's probably what I would vote for if I was in the Academy.
Yep.
But I think Roma is probably going to win.
Okay.
Roma's leading.
The consensus is 3-1 that Roma will win.
Mm-hmm.
My next thing, I think Green Book may pull it out, and they give for Roma Best Director and Best Foreign Film.
Because it is nominated.
Because Roma's up for Best Foreign Film as well.
I'm going to give Green Book Best Screenplay when we get to that.
Okay.
Okay.
So I'm going to put a pin in that.
Okay. All right. Go ahead.
Okay.
Nikki, let's do.
Oh, we're going to actor category.
Oh, hang on. Just a moment, please.
Yeah.
Stand by.
I love it. Okay. Lead actor, Christian Bale for Vice. Bradley Cooper for Star Is Born. Willem Dafoe at Eternity's Gate. Rami Malek for Bohemian Rhapsody. And Viggo Mortensen for Green Book.
Okay, Kelly.
Okay, I would love to stay in character, but I've got to put my peepers on so I can see. Well, I don't really have to see anything. Rami, for sure. And I've overanalyzed this. Like I say, I've seen Bohemian Rhapsody five times now, and I literally watched it back to back with Vice because Christian Bale is getting such a buzz from Vice, and he was brilliant. And part of that brilliance was hair and makeup and his just looking the part.
Agreed.
But I broke it down. Christy, this is becoming like cheerleader auditions. I broke it down. Christian Bale was more just upper body and face and voice and grovel in his tone and just kind of this being. And Rami Malek played basically five Freddie Mercurys. He played Freddie Mercury the immigrant. He played Freddie Mercury the beginning musician, then he played Freddie Mercury the rock star, then he played Freddie Mercury the flamboyant who am I phase of life, and then he played Freddie Mercury sick.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
And that spectrum and the physicality of this film, the movement, he had a movement coach and all the things that aren't necessarily in his wheelhouse.
Mm-hmm.
I just thought, you know, head to toe, I just think he brought more to the film than the others in this particular category.
Okay. And he has won. I mean, he's done very well.
This won Golden Globe.
But the thing about Golden Globe is you have the musical or comedy, and then you have the drama.
So, that's true.
You know, you have two categories within.
I don't listen. Yeah. He won SAG, which is great. He didn't win Critics' Choice.
Yeah, Christian Bale won that. So,
but I'm gonna jump up and scream when he wins. But I'm gonna be disappointed for him if he doesn't, because I think he just was a heck of an actor on this, and a musician, and a dancer, and it was just performance.
It's perfect.
Okay. So Kelly's pick is Rami Malek. Mm-hmm. Okay. My preference is Rami Malek.
Okay.
But Christian Bale's going to win.
Okay.
Yeah. I've seen all of these. I've not seen Willem Dafoe. I love Bradley Cooper in A Star is Born. Viggo Mortensen was terrific in Green Book. But have him as a lead actor and Mahershala Ali as the supporting actor. I mean, we know why they did that. It's so that both don't cancel each other out. So they both have a chance for nominations.
Yeah.
And wins. But that was Mahershala Ali was a lead role, in my opinion, in that film. But Christian Bale is just phenomenal.
He was. He owned that part. He did.
He's phenomenal. Yeah. And I love the movie Vice. I loved it.
It was good.
It was good. I saw it.
Okay.
It was salty.
I'm going with Rami Malek. That's who I'm going with. I just feel for Bohemian Rhapsody. I just feel like he's going
to pull it out. So you're predicting that you want him to win, and you're predicting that he wins.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Kent?
My preference is Bradley Cooper.
Okay. Now, is that a man crush, or is that music, art?
Yeah, I just thought he brought, like you said, what he did with Freddie Mercury.
Yeah, he did.
Bradley Cooper kind of had nothing to go off of, and he really brought so much of himself into that.
That's true.
The way he's like spiraled out of control, you know, he brought that.
You're right.
I thought he was great, you know, the way he learned how to sing and do that whole thing and pull that off.
And learned how to play the guitar.
And have to direct the movie at the same time. I was really impressed with what he did, but that's my preference, but I think Christian Bale is going to win.
Okay.
I mean, y'all know I started with Bradley Cooper, but that was before I'd seen Bohemian Rhapsody. That's a tough one. I mean, he was a great actor.
But, we're kind of showing our demographic by leaning towards Bohemian Rhapsody and Queen, because Kelly and I, you know, we were like in college when Live Aid came out and stuff. So it's right in our wheelhouse. Nikki and Kent are younger. But sometimes it just hits you because I remember exactly where I was when Queen took the stage for Live Aid. And I mean, my sister, we were just jumping up and down. I mean, it was just like, it was so fantastic.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And so to watch it, it brings back memories for you. Absolutely. I get that.
I can't say just the same, because I guess, to be honest with you, I'd forgotten so much of what Queen had done in their collection. So it reignited all that. Mm-hmm. And I just learned so much about the band, Brian May, and just the filming of it. I've watched now so many documentaries on how they made it, and documentaries on Freddie Mercury. And just for some reason, I'm just kind of fascinated with that. But it's so great, though, that this year we have so much music in the film. I don't know that we get that every year.
Yeah, I agree. I totally agree. Okay, we're going to move on to the next one?
Yes.
Okay, here we go. Lead actress, which is always my favorite category. All righty. Yalitza Aparicio for Roma. Glenn Close for The Wife, Olivia Colman for The Favorite, Lady Gaga for A Star is Born, and Melissa McCarthy for Can You Ever Forgive Me?
Okay. Kelly?
I haven't seen Melissa McCarthy, and I'm dying to, because that's just so intriguing. I know it's going to be great.
She's really good in it.
I'm going to go, okay, here's my football analysis. I'm going to go Glenn Close. She's been nominated seven times, and she hasn't won it, and she has earned an Oscar for multiple years. So it's kind of overdue. She's also can take any role, and she was great in The Wife. Mm-hmm. Lady Gaga is exciting and thrilling. So I was thinking about this today. Lady Gaga is the Patrick Mahomes here. Mm-hmm. And Glenn Close is, I'm blank, help me.
Tom Brady.
The Tom Brady. You've got this experience and this seasoned, and you know they're going to deliver, and you've got this exciting person that you know's got more and more to give. So I'm going Glenn Close. That's kind of how I see him. The only thing is that, you know, if everybody says, oh, Lady Gaga will have her day, I can't think of another role that could be any better for her than this role she just played.
Right.
Well, to your point, though, I feel like Lady Gaga almost played herself, you know, and I like it when an actor is challenged to play something that they are so far removed from. And I feel like she kind of played herself and a little bit of her story, So I don't know. I liked it. I loved it. I loved her performance. But I hear what you're saying about Glenn Close.
Yeah. Glenn Close is going to win.
Mm-hmm. She's going to win.
Yeah. Oh, I brought
it. I like how you're so definitive.
No, I brought another prop. This is... I actually got her autograph and met her one time after a show in New York.
Oh, how cool.
If you ever go to a Broadway show...
Yes.
Or even, you know, Music Hall at Fair Park or AT&T here in Dallas, if you hang out outside the stage door, you get autographs and meet people, and they almost always stop and sign. So whether it's Audra McDonald or, you know, anyway, so Glenn Close, this was a show that she did with Sam, you'll recognize Sam Waterston from his Law and Order days and all of that, and Mary Beth Hurt there. But anyway, Glenn Close, when she came out to greet people, she was wearing a letter jacket, like a high school letter mm-hmm. jacket. And it was had a K on it for the Knights. She had it was her cast gift jacket from when she filmed The Natural with Robert Redford.
Oh wow!
Right,
oh,
remember so that cool. where she was the girlfriend and that.
I do remember.
And
that.
So anyway, they the whole cast and crew they got these jackets and they were made up for the team, the fictional team that Roy Hobbs played for, the Knights. That was Robert Redford's character. But anyway,
that's
so
great.
But yeah, mm-hmm. so Glenn Close, I believe, is going to win.
Okay.
But
and you want her to win? I mean, your tone.
Oh sure, of course. I mean, but my choice would be I loved Olivia Colman in The Favourite. Mm-hmm. She played Queen Anne. And then Rachel Weisz and Emma Stone, mm-hmm. who were nominated for Supporting Actress. I think they kind of flipped it here because those two roles had more screen time and were a little bigger.
Right.
But they were the, like, ladies in waiting that were vying for her time and affection and everything. But she is just amazing as Queen Anne in The Favourite. But Yalitza Aparicio, what's amazing about that, she's only the second woman from Mexico to be nominated for Best Actress.
Really?
The other is Selma Hayek from...
That surprises me.
Yeah.
Me too.
When she did Frida.
Mm-hmm.
And also, this is her first movie. I mean, she's never been in a movie, and right. it's nominated for Best Picture, and she's nominated for Best Actress. She's a teaching student, a grad student, and she gets cast in this and is just so wonderful.
And it's like, how does that even happen? I mean, did she try out?
There was a casting call.
Wow.
There was a casting call that she answered. And by the way, Melissa McCarthy, fantastic in this movie. I think I may be the only one here that's seen.
Can yeah,
you
I
ever
not
forgive
seen it.
Me? It is not a sympathetic character. It's based on a true story. A writer, a biographer who's on some hard times financially and is about to lose her, you know, owes rent on her apartment there in New York City and all that kind of stuff, and starts forging letters from famous people like Dorothy Parker and Fanny Bryce and the like. And, you know, it starts off innocently, but then she keeps going because she's getting like $300, $400
wow.
for these forged deals. And so she's using her writing skills to fake all this stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And
she's
but
selling it as memorabilia.
She's selling it as memorabilia. She's selling it to these bookstores and these collectors.
Yes.
Sell it to these collectors. And the guy who is nominated for Best Supporting Actor, he is fantastic in this movie. But she is not, it's not, it is so un-Melissa McCarthy.
I know, and I love that.
Great.
Me too.
I can't wait to see her in a non-comedy role.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And this is definitely it because, you know, you sympathize with her, but then there are some other things where it's just like, oh, yeah.
Good for her.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so I'm predicting Glenn Close, mm-hmm. but my preference is Olivia Colman.
Okay. I'm going to predict Glenn Close as well, just because of how well she's been doing this award season. But I would also like to see Olivia Colman win it.
Okay.
But I'm predicting Glenn Close.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, Kent.
Preference Lady Gaga, but my prediction is probably Glenn Close too.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, like you say, it's a body of work kind of thing, right, Kelly?
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
And it's interesting. Was it the Golden Globes that let them tie? They tied. Was it Golden?
Yeah. By the way, I do have some notes on some things, and there have been a couple of ties in history.
In Oscars?
In Oscar history. Uh-huh.
Wow.
Yeah, it's happened. Their ties have been in documentary, short film, and sound editing.
What years?
So, in 1931/32 for Best Actor, Wallace Beery for The Champ, and Frederick March for Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. In 1968, you'll know these actresses: Funny Girl, mm-hmm. Barbara Streisand, and Katharine Hepburn for The Lion and Winner.
I thought Barbara won it. Period. Flat out.
No, she shared it. She shared it, Funny Girl, with Katharine Hepburn.
Okay. Interesting.
Interesting. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes.
So it's happened twice. I'm not saying it won't happen again.
So 68 is the last time that's happened.
It happened in sound editing just 7 years ago in 2012 for Zero Dark Thirty and for Skyfall, which was the James Bond film. Sound editing. Paul Audison and Per Halberg and Karen Baker Landers for the James Bond film.
All right.
Okay. Is there a superlative there on how many times they called out the wrong Best Picture at the end of the awards? Like they did a couple.
Yeah.
So that never happened before.
Oh my God.
How epic was that?
Yes.
That was awful.
Oh man. So bad. Warren Beatty and Faye Dunaway. They bring out Bonnie and Clyde who steal the moment from Moonlight.
That's right. Moonlight.
And announced La La Land.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my goodness.
Wow.
Okay. Epic.
Yes, it was.
My jaw dropped.
I was like, is this really happening?
I kind of thought it was some type of.
And you know why it happened, right?
There's been so many theories.
The guy from the accounting firm who's like handing the envelope was taking a selfie
backstage.
That's right.
Handed him the wrong envelope, right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. There's all this conspiracy theory. That'll be at our next screenplay is what really happened.
Okay, next category, supporting actor. Mahershala Ali for Green Book.
This is a tough one.
Adam Driver for BlacKkKlansman. Sam Elliott, A Star is Born. Richard E. Grant, Can You Ever Forgive Me? And Sam Rockwell for Vice. Okay.
Oh, am I going first on this one? Okay. Okay, Sam Rockwell won last year, by the way.
He won best
for Three Billboards.
Oh, yes.
Okay.
So good.
And Adam Driver's terrific in BlacKkKlansman. Sam mm-hmm. Elliott is fantastic in everything. He could steal. I won't say steal this. He could get this similar to Glenn Close body of work kind of thing because mm-hmm. he's just been so great mm-hmm. for so long.
Has he never won or?
He's been, after decades of work, this is his first nomination.
Yeah.
Wow. Are you serious?
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. But my prediction is Mahershala Ali, mm-hmm. well-deserved. My preference is Richard E. Grant for Can You Ever Forgive Me? But okay. Mahershala Ali, I predict it'll either be him or Sam Elliott. I'm going to go with Ali, the greatest.
Okay.
And this is a tough category because Mahershala. Got to learn how to. And he needs a nickname. Let's just go with
Ali.
Hirsch. Mahersh will win. He's won everything up to this point, and he's just been outstanding in the role. I did really like what Sam Elliott brought to A Star Is Born.
Yeah.
I like his grit, his texture. He gave. Mm-hmm. He just kind of gave some real depth to the film that was could possibly be overlooked. But I think Mahershala will win, and that is my final answer. I love Sam Rockwell. He deserved it in Three Bridges last year. I think his role in this year was so small.
Yeah.
I wanted more of him, and you just didn't. He was totally overshadowed.
He plays George Bush.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And to Dick Cheney's Vice.
Yes.
To Christian Bale's Dick Cheney, for those who haven't seen the film.
You just don't see him that much, so you just don't get to appreciate him as much as I think. I don't think that role compared to last year's role in Three Billboards warrants the same trophy.
Gotcha.
Okay,
Nikki. I agree with you, Kelly, that this is a tough category. I agree that my prediction will be Mahershala Ali for Green Book. And I did love Sam Elliott in A Star Is Born. I mean, I thought he was just like the great big brother,
mm-hmm.
you know, he was mm-hmm. so protective and I don't know. And like you said, the grittiness, I loved him in that role.
Yeah.
So
Kent, Kent, let's get the male perspective on this.
Mahershala for the win. Mm-hmm. Preference, Sam Elliott.
Okay.
Okay, so we're the same.
Interesting.
Yeah, mm-hmm. we're the same. I'm the only one that went with Can You Ever Forgive Me for Richard E. Grant, but...
Is that your prediction?
No, my prediction is Mahershala Ali. Okay, my preference is Richard E. Grant. Ah. But yes, we all predict Mahershala Ali.
Hey, Christypedia, let me ask you a question.
Uh-oh.
Was Sam Elliott in the Barbra Streisand 76?
No, I don't believe so.
Stars Born? I'd heard that. And so well, that common it might have been kind of cool.
Was he? Must have been in earlier role. In his career, a lesser role. I don't remember.
Oh, certainly
him
a lesser
from
role,
it.
But I heard yeah. that was kind of a cool common.
That
thread.
Would be neat. Yeah,
that is cool.
I'm not familiar with that. Although a couple of things about A Star Is Born and what's really interesting. So, by the way, since you brought up Christopedia, so Lady Gaga is not the first original, you know, double threat as a singer and actress. But Barbra Streisand won Best Actress for Funny Girl and Best Original Song for Evergreen from A Star Is Born in 1976.
Now that makes perfect sense.
Now here's what's really interesting about, you talk about star-making roles. Mm-hmm. A Star Is Born does that. The lead characters of three different versions of A Star Is Born have been nominated. So,
fascinating.
1937.
That's a good role to get.
1937, Janet Gaynor as Esther Blodgett. Okay, so she's 1937.
And that was the first one.
In 1954, Judy Garland as Esther Blodgett gets nominated. And now Lady Gaga, of course, the name of her character in Bradley Cooper's version is Allie. Three different lead characters. Janet Gaynor, three different actresses for playing the same lead role in the same movie. And then the male leads in 1937, Frederick March. He played, the name of the character was Norman Maine. So in 1954, Judy Garland, James Mason played Norman Maine. And now Bradley Cooper, of course, he named his character Jackson Maine. But the male leads, Frederick March, James Mason, and Bradley Cooper.
Do y'all have a preference, Kris Kristofferson or Bradley Cooper in that role?
I liked Bradley Cooper.
Oh, yeah, Bradley Cooper. Mm-hmm. But, I mean, Kris Kristofferson was
good.
Great.
Mm-hmm.
Kris Kristofferson was great.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
What about you? Did you have a preference?
You have a preference? Obviously, yes. It's Bradley Cooper.
Yeah.
But Kris Kristofferson.
But Kris Kristofferson kind of gave him the blueprint, I think, for that character.
Mm-hmm. I would agree.
Kris Kristofferson has been down as a guest on the Cowboys sideline before a game. It was at Texas Stadium, probably mid to late 90s. Must have been mid to early 90s. I don't know if you got a chance to meet him.
But I did not.
But yeah, he was down there for one of the games.
That's very cool.
Yeah.
Okay, next category. Supporting actress. This is another tough one.
There are two.
We've got Amy Adams for Vice, Marina de Tavira for Roma, Regina King for If Beale Street Could Talk, Emma Stone, The Favorite, and Rachel Weisz. Is that how you pronounce
Vice.
It? Vice for The Favorite.
While I'm flipping pages, can one of y'all take this? I'm going to.
Okay, yes.
This is tough.
Actually, I think I love Emma Stone and Rachel in The Favorite because that was my favorite movie of the year. They should be in the lead actress category instead of supporting actress. Unfortunately, I think they're going to cancel each other out. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Because they're just so great in it. I love Amy Adams, and she is fantastic in Vice. But Marina de Tavira in Roma is fantastic. That was the big surprise.
Mm-hmm.
She was the surprise nomination. I think Regina King's going to pull this off. My prediction is Regina King. I'm going out on a limb because there's a surprise every year.
There is a surprise every year.
But I'm going to go with Rachel for The Favorite as my personal pick.
Okay.
But my prediction is Regina King. Although I love Amy Adams. I love Amy Adams too. But
I do love Amy Adams.
Okay.
Okay, my turn. Okay. Oh, I agree with you. The two for The Favorites are going to cancel themselves out. That always seems to happen when there's two from the same movie. I don't know. I haven't seen If Beale Street Could Talk, but I heard it's fabulous, and I heard she does a great job, so I'll go with her. But I would love to see the upset with Marina de Tavira from Roma. So I'm going to go out on a limb and say Marina de Tavira is going to win it, but I'd love to see Regina King win it.
I think Regina King has a lot of people rallying for her, like I am for Rami. I don't know. Uh-huh. It's just kind of uh-huh. something.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
She...
And rightfully so. I mean, great body of work for her.
Definitely.
You know? And I loved her in Jerry Maguire.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I actually maybe would say I liked that role as much or more. I did see the film, and I really, really liked it. I think she is going to win, but I equally think Amy Adams' role is as deserving.
Yeah, she's amazing.
As Lynn Cheney. So I'm kind of torn on this one. I think that's kind of a toss-up.
Yeah.
I think Regina King has the trophy to beat. I mean, I think she has it close, mm-hmm. and she's the one that will have to be...
Yeah.
Have to it be taken from. Okay. I didn't think it was just like an outstanding... I don't know. I wasn't as... It wasn't like my most memorable performance of a female actress, mm-hmm. nor was none of them really. And the Roma, I guess I'm on the record. I'm just not a real fan of that film, so mm-hmm. I'm not going there. But I'm Regina King or Amy Adams, because Regina King seems to be getting a lot of really good critical acclaim. Mm-hmm. I'm going to go Regina King.
Okay. Kay. Kent?
Regina King for the win, preference, one of the favorites.
Yeah. Okay. Can I go Christopedia on you here for a minute?
Please.
On Rachel Weisz's character? So she is in the film, she is like the number one person closest to Queen Anne, Olivia Colman's character. This is based in reality. Mm-hmm. So, and she's married to Lord Marlborough, who goes off and is fighting the French. But she's the one that has the Queen's ear. And you talk about it, devious, manipulative. Oh my gosh. But she's really smart. But she really is the one with the power, because she does all the daily stuff for the Queen.
Okay.
And so she's the one that's really in charge, because she manipulates the Queen.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. In real life, Sarah Churchill, this historical fact.
Okay.
Rachel is playing a woman named Sarah Churchill. And then when she marries the guy, and then later they name the Duke of Marlborough and stuff.
Okay.
Churchill, yes, a forebear of Winston Churchill. And also a forebear, her granddaughter was... No, listen. It gets better.
That's so inadequate. Can I make a dunce cap?
No. Diana Spencer was her granddaughter, which means her great, 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 anyway, one of her great, down the line,
my goodness.
Diana Spencer, as in Princess of Diana. Wales, mm-hmm. which means that Prince William and Prince Harry are part of the lineage of Sarah Churchill, the character played in The Favorite.
Wow.
Is that crazy?
That is.
I watched the film and I want to know more about Queen Anne, because this is really interesting. And I want to know how close this tracks to reality.
Mm-hmm.
And all three characters were, you know, it's fact. You know, they existed. And then obviously they take a lot of artistic license and stuff. But Queen Anne is kind of shown as, you know, kind of doddering. She has really poor health and stuff. But when she was the Queen of England, that's when Ireland and Scotland came in and it became the United Kingdom. So,
interesting. Wow.
Yeah, there's lots of historical context in that.
Professor yes. Christy Scales.
No, wow.
I feel inadequate.
No, I just thought people might find, if you've seen the film,
yes.
or if you're going to see
it. I will.
It, yes. then, but anyway, just think, oh, that character that she plays, Sarah, Lady Marlborough, is, was related to Winston Churchill and Prince William and Prince Harry and Lady Diana.
That's crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-mm-mm. Okay, so next category is Best Director.
Is Kevin Bacon in there?
6 degrees of separation.
That's good. That's really good.
Awesome.
All right, we've got Spike Lee for Black Klansman.
Okay, wait, which category are
this
we on?
This is Director.
Best Director. Mm-hmm. Got it.
Oh.
Powell Palakowski for Cold War. Yorgos Lanthimos for The Favorite, Alfonso Cuarón for Roma, and Adam McKay for Vice.
Yeesh. Okay. Who wants to go first? Kent, you go first,
yes.
since you haven't gone first
Roma.
Yet. Roma? Okay, Alfonso Cuarón. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Prediction and preference? Or prediction?
Yeah, probably.
Okay. I'll go next. It's Cuarón all the way.
Mm-hmm.
Although my preference would be Yorgos for The Favorite, because I like that film. But Alfonso Cuarón is my prediction.
I'll go next. I will agree that Alfonso Cuarón will take it, but I would love to see Spike Lee.
Wouldn't that be amazing?
Yes.
That would be so amazing. Fantastic if he, mm-hmm. if he did.
Mm-hmm. I'm 100% with Nikki. I think Roma's director will take it, and I would love to see Spike Lee win as well. And I think what he did with his film was surprising. I mean, I don't know. It kind of came out of nowhere, and it's Spike Lee, and it was unpredictable, and I really enjoyed it. I'd like to see Spike Lee win. Roma keeps becoming a household name.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay.
Agreed. All righty. So then now we're going to skip over some of these. We're going to go right to original song. This will be the last one.
We want to get in Kelly's wheelhouse here.
We will cover. All right, here we go. Original song, All the Stars from Black Panther by Kendrick Lamar and SZA. I'll Fight from RBG by Diane Warren and Jennifer Hudson.
I love
it. The Place Where Lost Things Go from Mary Poppins Returns by Mark Shaiman, Scott Whitman. Shallow from A Star Is Born by Lady Gaga, Mark Ronson, and a bunch of other people. When a Cowboy...
Okay. That ain't fair to their mamas. No, they can't say that when they get up there. Oh, a bunch of other people helped.
Sorry. When a Cowboy Trades His Spurs for Wings from The Ballad of Buster Scruggs by David Rawlings and Gillian Welch.
Okay. By the way, if you have Netflix...
Yes.
Do the thing from The Ballad of Buster Scruggs. It's a Coen Brothers. If you like the Coen Brothers but yes. haven't seen this, mm-hmm. you've got to see The Ballad of Buster Scruggs.
It okay.
It's a takeoff on all things Western. It is different. So you need to kind of be, you need to like the Coen Brothers work.
I do.
But
it's a little creepy sometimes.
It's very different. Yeah. Okay.
Can I start with this?
Yes.
Okay. So I've listened to all of the songs. And I am so curious how the songs become nominated, because every last one of these songs is different.
Hmm.
What do you guys think?
They are very different.
Very different.
That's a good question. Let me look into that, because I have mm-hmm. a friend that's actually in the Academy, and they get he's makeup, and they get all the screeners, and they view them at home and they fill out the ballots. But I don't know in the music category. I don't know if they sit back and watch the film or if they're actually sent soundtrack score. Mm-hmm.
My bet would be that the production companies send CDs or downloads or whatever, so that people, you know, because there's a lot of money with these nominations.
For sure.
They're pushing it.
I mean, you mentioned Evergreen with Barbara Streisand. Mm-hmm. Look how timeless some of the songs that have won in the past.
Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm. Right.
Become.
Exactly.
So this is hard. I liked I'll Fight by Diane Warren and Jennifer Hudson, but I'm going to say my favorite is going to have to be Shallow from A Star Is Born. Just going to put it out there.
Mm-hmm. Kelly?
I loved Shallow in A Star Is Born. The first time I heard it, I loved it. I actually liked the song at the end of the film as well, I'll Never Love Again. I thought it was actually more epic. We talked about it. I thought it was mm-hmm. kind of the Titanic Bodyguard Whitney Houston song, but Shallow is so popular globally, and they do a beautiful, brilliant job. I think the kind of something that's interesting, and you say, how did it get nominated? When I'm sitting in a film and all of a sudden just a song, immediately I start taking notes or I want to download it and study it later. Mm-hmm. It was Where the Lost Things Go from Mary Poppins. I was so moved by that sweet, mm-hmm. Comforting lullaby type of song that was basically, she was singing to the children and telling them that their mother's not gone forever, but she's in this special place where lost things go. And it was very comforting. It's beautiful. And she sings beautifully.
She does.
You actually hear
Emily Blunt. How does Emily Blunt not get nominated this year?
I don't know.
A Quiet Place, Mary Poppins. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Man, it's a strong group of contenders this year. She gets shut out.
Totally.
So I think that I'm so thrilled that song got nominated, yes. because that is one of two songs that I wrote down this entire movie season, and it just oddly popped out to me. So I think it does have something magical in it that will be timeless.
Okay.
But my vote is still Shallow.
Okay.
Okay. My preference is Mary Poppins. The Place Where Lost Things Go, because it made me cry.
It did me too.
Yeah. And so, and I absolutely love Shallow. I mean, it's a fantastic song. So I'm predicting Shallow to win, but my preference is Mary Poppins.
Okay. Kent, what about you?
Shallow for the win.
Shallow for the win.
And preference.
And preference. Okay.
All right.
Okay.
The want and the win?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay.
All right.
Aren't they doing it? Aren't they performing it?
Yes, they are. And
they
you know,
that'll
be
interesting.
Awesome. Do you think that they're
steamy.
Since there's not a host this year and all the controversy with the hosting and Kevin Hart and everything, do you think they open with Bradley Cooper and Lady Gaga? Would that be the way to epically open a show?
That'd be nice.
If you don't have Billy Crystal singing a thing,
I think that's
or
a great idea.
Ellen DeGeneres doing something.
I like that idea.
I do too.
That'd be nice.
Wouldn't that be fantastic? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it would. Oh, and it'll be so good to hear them sing that live and together.
Did y'all see their little surprise concert performance in Las Vegas? I think it was like last week or 2 weeks
ago.
Well,
she's doing a residency show
and out of nowhere she goes, "I've got a friend tonight." And then he walks out and he sits on that piano bench and he sings that song with her and it was steamy.
Wow.
Ooh, maybe that's how they'll do for the Oscars. Of course, I heard him saying he was like, oh, he is so scared about performing. If I were him, I would want to open the show so that
just
I
could get it over
get
with.
It over
yes.
With
and you know, that's
relax the rest of
to sing in front of that audience.
Oh my gosh.
Can't imagine.
I would think that would be the most intimidating audience
absolutely.
In the entire world, because you look out and these faces that are looking back at you, you've just admired and they're so recognizable, you know, that would be so scary.
Agreed. Agreed.
Let's hope he doesn't take on his movie character and fall on the stage with too much beverage beforehand.
Kent, do we have time for a couple of movie trivia? Or did we want to hit any of the other categories?
Before? Okay, I have something I was a little confused, so I did too much research on adapted script.
You want to do screenplay.
I think A Star is Born is going to be overlooked in most of it.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
But I do think it should and could get adapted screenplay. Okay. So after doing research, what's the difference between screenplay and adapted screenplay?
Yep.
Adapted screenplay is when they take, when they make a film about a book, a play, a TV show, or a former film.
Okay.
And the way they reinvented A Star is Born so beautifully and so relevant and current, yet it still is A Star is Born. I want it to get adapted screenplay.
Okay.
So the nominees for adapted screenplay are The Ballad of Buster Scruggs by the Coen Brothers, BlacKkKlansman, Can You Ever Forgive Me, If Beale Street Could Talk, and A Star is Born. So all of that content previously existed somewhere, and so these writers, or in this case, you know, the Coen Brothers are also direct, you know, they adapted it for their particular movie.
The BlacKkKlansman was a memoir. Can You Ever Forgive Me was a memoir. Mm-hmm. Beale Street Could Talk was a novel by James Baldwin. And then A Star is Born, of course, is the films that we previously discussed. Did I miss one there?
Ballad of Buster Scruggs.
Ooh. Well, okay. Printing problem.
Okay. all right. Prediction. Yeesh. Yeah, I'll go with A Star is Born on this. Bradley Cooper is one of three nominees. And it would be great if he won this. You know, he did not get nominated for director and maybe bypassed and, you know, actor and stuff. So this is probably, as an individual, not for the film, but as an individual, this is probably his best chance.
I think it is. I think it's perfect. Oscar. How do you reinvent something for the fourth time?
Yes.
Uh-huh. And make it
fresh.
This...
Make it so fresh.
I think it's perfect and I think it's well-deserved.
I agree.
Okay.
What about you, Kent?
Kent, do you have a preference or?
Preference, BlacKkKlansman.
Yeah, that was just a great movie.
Prediction? This one's tough. Maybe A Star is Born, probably.
Okay.
Okay.
Original screenplay. So this is, they came up, you know, like The Favorite. It's based on history, but they did it themselves. So The Favorite, First Reformed, which was, that's the one I think where Ethan Hawke got overlooked as an actor.
Okay.
Nominee. Green Book, Roma, and Vice. I want to say one thing about Green Book. If you haven't seen the movie, you don't understand what Green Book references. Mm-hmm. It's in the South, there was like a AAA guide, mm-hmm. a travel guide, when the South was segregated still, of restaurants and hotels where African Americans could stay. And so what happens is the Viggo Mortensen character is driving the Mahershala Ali character, this great pianist, and giving concerts and stuff throughout the South. And so he refers to the Green Book to find a place for Mahershala Ali's character to stay, mm-hmm. or restaurants that they can go to, because Mahershala Ali was not welcome even to eat in places where he performed, his character performed.
Yeah. Gotcha. Mm-hmm. So... is that your prediction for original screenplay?
My preference is The Favorite. Ooh. You know what? I'm going to go with Vice.
Okay.
I liked Vice. It's got to win something.
For original screenplay?
Mm-hmm.
How original is...
Well, it's all of it's based on stuff. Green Book is based on history. The Favorite is based on history.
And Roma, was that?
I guess I think of screenplay as who wrote
Cuarón, yeah.
A great story.
It was based on his experiences as a young person. And Roma refers to a neighborhood in Mexico mm-hmm. City.
Okay.
So he was drawing upon his experiences as a kid.
Okay.
But yes, Cuarón, who directed the film, came up, wrote it, so...
I'm going to challenge you on that one. I'm going to give screenplay, best original screenplay written for film. I'm giving it to Green Book. I thought it was compelling. It was interesting. It's an important story to tell. Mm-hmm. It's timely. But I thought I loved the human nature of how, these two very different people have to survive together.
Mm-hmm.
It comes full circle. I thought it was a very beautiful story.
Oh, yeah.
And for that, and they captured it on film, and it was actually, half of the story was kind of told in a car.
Yeah, that's great.
So I'm going
Green Book. Almost a Driving Miss Daisy.
Exactly.
No, really.
Very similar.
Yeah, and I was
one, and it won one, Golden Globes.
Yes, and one of the ones who's nominated is Peter Farrelly. This is the Farrelly brothers. Mm-hmm. You can't get more different. Green Book and a Farrelly Brothers movie. So good for him. I mean, that would be really exciting if he won.
I'm going to go Green Book too.
Now, Green Book was, correct me if I'm wrong, wasn't it written by the son of the driver? When he accepted it, he talked about my father.
Yeah, there's,
that's right.
And also the guy, the Viggo mm-hmm. Mortensen character, I think, and Kent may chime in here if he knows. I believe that in real life, he ended up being one of the guys who was an actor in The Sopranos.
Oh, wow.
Certainly crazy? Looks like that.
Yeah, uh-huh.
But I think his son wrote that story, which makes it even, I don't know.
More, it makes it more personal and
his acceptance
uh-huh.
speech kind of.
Yeah.
Moved me.
What about you, Kent? What do you think? Original screenplay.
Green Book.
Green Book.
Green Book. Green Book and Green Book. Okay.
Yep.
Yep. Yep. I think that one will probably win, but like I say, I'll go with Vice.
Okay. Any others you want to cover?
Hair and makeup, just because
that's kind of
my world and my friends.
Go for it.
Hair and makeup's going to go to Vice. What they did to Christian Bale.
Christian Bale.
Mm-hmm.
Amazing.
You talk about the brilliance of prosthetic and hair and all there the stuff is. They do uh-huh. to... plump people up and age them. That's easy for me. Now, I hope I'm right, but that's a no-brainer for me.
It's going against Mary, Queen of Scots and Border. And, of course, Mary, Queen of Scots, haven't seen that one yet, but they take Margot Robbie and have the splotchy, the skin condition
mm-hmm.
thing. Anyway, but...
And the red, didn't Mary, Queen of Scots have that just red hair?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
So, if I'm wrong, we're going to do a call, dial a friend with my Hollywood friend David,
so he's,
who's in
he's,
that he's business Vice. And has three
was,
Emmys.
Was he part of Vice?
No.
Okay.
Actually, he just won his Emmy for the Versace, the assassination
really?
Of Versace.
Really? Yeah. Wow. That's so he awesome. Got to work with Darren Criss and all those folks?
Yep.
How wonderful.
So
wow,
cool.
That's really cool.
So that's the word on the street. That's the only insider information I have.
Okay, so what about costumes then? The nominees are Ballad of Buster Scruggs, Black Panther, The Favorite, Mary Poppins Returns, and Mary, Queen of Scots.
Mm.
Because I haven't seen The Favorite and Mary, Queen of Scots, which I'm sure is fabulously dramatic. Those mm-hmm. I'm probably missing something, but I'm just from the pictures I've seen and the part of Black Panther, the first half of Black Panther that I saw, that's a pretty elaborate
mm-hmm.
wardrobe.
Yeah. Yep.
So I'm just going to kind of guess here that it's Black Panther.
Okay.
I haven't seen the others. Were they fabulous? Or
yes, but, you know, Mary, Queen of Scots and The Favorite, it's, you know, the old, mm-hmm. you know,
yeah.
the costumes from the monarch, English monarchy and yes. stuff. But also the makeup was really, it's not nominated, but in The Favorite, you know, the men with the wigs and mm-hmm. the white face, and they would dot the moles on, mm-hmm. you know, but it was fantastic too. So yeah, I don't know.
I don't either.
I'll go with The Favorite just because I like The Favorite.
Let's see here. I agree. I loved the costumes in Black Panther, so I'm going with Black Panther.
Okay. Kent, you got to make a choice.
Let's go with Mary, Queen of Scots.
Okay. All right. Okay. All right.
Undercard.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Awesome.
Any other categories you guys want to hit?
There was sound mixing and sound editing, which, Kent, you probably can tell us more. I allowed myself to get confused yeah. there. But if I did my research right, mixing was described as, standby. I loved First Man's score. I mm-hmm. loved that score mm-hmm. in the film. It's the first thing I noticed.
It was,
and it wasn't nominated. There's not a score per se category unless I missed it. But editing was described as the finest, most aesthetic sound design or sound editing or creation of sound effects. So I thought, okay, is that the rockets on First Man or is it, what is it? But I think editing to me sounds like what I heard in Black Panther because there's so much sound, vocal, music, drums, all of that. And then the mixing was defined as the most euphonic sound mixing or recording going to the production mixers. Previous mixing wins was Raiders of the Lost Ark, Sniper, Zero Dark Thirty, these real dramatic sounds. So that one I thought the mixing might go to
First Man on that one? Or?
Yes.
Uh-huh. First Man. Okay.
Or yeah, because okay. Bohemian Rhapsody is just a great live mm-hmm. Queen
right.
redo.
Yeah, the sound mixing nominations are Black Panther, Bohemian Rhapsody, First Man, Roma, and A Star is Born. Kent, since you're the production yes. expert.
I would go mixing Bohemian Rhapsody.
Really?
Okay.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Over First Man.
Just because the concert level. And...
Well, A Star is Born, too. There's yeah, some good, of that as well with the, you know, kind of similar where you have some music
yep.
parts there. But yeah, the way they recreated the Live Aid and everything was fantastic in Bohemian Rhapsody.
Well, I'm down with that. I didn't, if I kind of maybe misinterpreted the way they were describing it, but that's great.
No, mm-hmm. yeah. Okay, sound editing, Kent. The nominees are Black Panther, Bohemian yeah. Rhapsody, First Man, A Quiet Place, and Roma.
I'll go with A Quiet Place.
Yeah, personally. A Quiet Place. That is such a great movie. Have y'all seen A Quiet mm-mm. Place?
Nope.
That's the one where they can make no sounds or the aliens eat them. That's
oh, gosh.
That's the Emily Blunt, John Krasinski. So they don't, it's the least dialogue since Marley Matlin won for Children of a Lesser God.
Oh, wow. Wow.
She did sign language for that, by the way. That's a joke. Anyway, but yeah, oh, that's a great, I'm with you, Kent. I loved A Quiet Place. You can hear like the rustle of the grass and the leaves and the trees. And mm-hmm. But anyway, it's John Krasinski and Emily Blunt played a married couple with three little kids. That's the one where she has the baby in the bathtub and can't scream. Because if she makes a sound, she's going to
what
get eaten by the alien.
Baby in the bathtub takes me back to Shape of Water last year. That
this is a very different bathtub scene.
But Kent, you saw it, right?
I'm tired of water. You can't make a sound. The aliens that eat people, is it aliens or just these monsters? But whatever.
They're, yeah.
It's not necessarily.
They're attracted to sound.
Yeah, so, they're yeah. attracted to sound. So if you know, like what happened, well, I shouldn't
sounds
say
creepy.
What happens early. Yeah, it's very scary. It's very tense. It's a great, great, great movie.
Well, I'm going to go out on a limb on the sound editing and go for Roma, because with it being a foreign language film and you're having to read the subtitles, what you did hear was so important. I felt like, especially the opening scene where she's cleaning the driveway or like where they yeah. parked their car.
Uh-huh.
And it took a while to figure out what was going on. You're just water splashing and then you hear that scrubbing sound. It's mm-hmm. like, what are we doing?
Mm-hmm.
So I would say Roma.
Yeah. Yeah, it's really effective.
Yep.
Okay. All right. Can I real quickly? You've got a couple of trivia questions
here.
Okay. And if you get the question correct, you get to reach in and grab some movie candy out of the bag.
Oh my goodness.
All right.
Krista, you've outdone yourself. You are going to be a great room mom.
But so actually, we got to plug in for Albertsons and Tom Thumb. I got my little Whit
and
bag.
And our dear Jason Whit.
Love it.
So shout out to Whit. All right. The all-time record for most wins in an acting category is 4. So a person has won 4 Oscars for acting.
Jack Nicholson?
Good guess.
Katherine Hepburn.
Yay! Good job, Nikki. Reach in and grab. These are all candies that you will find at a theater.
I'm going to call gender discrimination. I thought you said actor as in a man.
Acting. Okay. Well, let's go. All right. I don't want to throw anybody off here.
Penalty.
So that's why I said who. Okay. All right. Which male actor holds the record for the most nominations? This one male actor,
Tom Hanks,
has been nominated 12 times.
Making this up. Tom Hanks.
No, good guess, but no.
You already said him.
Jack Nicholson?
Yes.
Reach in again. Oh my gosh, y'all, come on.
Here.
Okay.
You already said him.
Lemonheads.
Love Lemonheads.
Okay, here we go. And Kent, you can buzz in here if you want as well. Okay. Which person, actor or actress, male or female, which person holds the record for the most Academy Award nominations? This person has been nominated 21 times. Kent, buzz in.
Meryl Streep.
Ding, 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 ding. May I draw? Here, Kelly, you draw for Kent.
Give me chocolate.
Chocolate?
I think there is one of chocolate in there.
Yeah. Oh, milk duds.
All right.
It's milk duds.
Okay. All right. The record for most Oscar wins by an individual film is 11. 3 different films have won 11 Oscars. So whether it could be like best film and screenplay and acting and costume. So 3 different films have won 11 Academy Awards.
Do we have to name all three?
Name one of them. We'll see if we can collectively come up with all 3.
Schindler's List?
No, actually, Schindler's List did not win Best Picture. That was the year that Gwyneth Paltrow, Shakespeare in Love. Is that right?
Yes.
Shakespeare in Love beat out.
I'm going
to
say.
They do not have to win Best Film, by the way, but that's a good guess, but it did not win.
Titanic.
Ding, ding, ding.
Ding, ding,
ding.
You
got one. Okay.
That's one. And there's 3?
There are 3. Okay. Think of back in Roman days and.
Roman days. Spark.
Chariots.
Oh, what's
and,
his name?
Chariots.
What's his name?
Ben-Hur.
Crazy.
Ben-Hur. Well done.
I'm thinking.
Okay. There's one left.
Oh, my kids.
And this would be. No, this was very recent. Well, I mean, 2003. It was nominated for 17 awards. It won 11. There might have been a Hobbit involved.
Oh.
Lord of the Rings.
Lord of the Rings. Ding, 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 ding. Okay.
Kent, you did not chime in.
Yeah, you didn't chime in, Kent.
Okay.
You're faster than me.
Okay. There you go.
Draw. Are we drawing for?
Draw.
Wait. Oh, this is for Kent? Who's this for?
No, this is for you. You got it.
Nikki said it.
I knew you had it, though.
Skittles.
I could see it in your eye.
Okay, final one, because we're way past our time. All right. Most awards won by an individual.
Ooh, I know this one.
Most awards won by an individual. Okay, so let's
different categories.
Yeah, so let's let Kelly and Kent see if they can
in 1 year.
No, most awards won by an individual in that person's career.
So just the as most acclaimed Hollywood person. Okay,
I'll give you a hint. Not an actor.
So not an actor. Actress. So we're female.
Not an actor or actress.
Oh.
It's not a director.
What do you?
This person would be a filmmaker, a creator.
Steven Spielberg.
No, that's a good guess.
Scorsese?
No. Not a director. Not a director.
Not an actor, not an actress, not a director.
This person may have directed some of their stuff, but basically just think of like creating things and content and movies.
Walt Disney.
Excellent.
22.
I tried to give you a hint. 22. We're going there.
I was going to say, give Oscars. Me some ears or something.
Well, I was going to say he has a world named after him in Florida and a land named after him in California. Yeah. So anyway. Okay.
That surprised me.
This is for you. Yeah. 22 Oscars. So, good and plenty, Kent. Congratulations. Woo. I hope you like licorice. So, anyway.
That was fun. All.
Yeah, so we appreciate it. Thank you. And Kent, thanks for playing us out.
Yes, thank you, Kent.
Kelly,
February 24th.
That's
are
right.
Are the Oscars.
God, I can't wait.
I can't either.
We're going to get together after the Oscars.
Yes, let's do it.
And we'll review.
We've got to review dresses. We've got to review the production numbers. And then, of course.
We should just reserve an hour for that show. I think we should.
And Kent, you have to do it too, okay? Because your predictions are part of this as
Okey-doke.
Well.
Okie doke.
Okay.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much, Kelly, for joining us.
That was my pleasure.
A lot of fun. Thank you, Christy, for all the goodies.
Sure.
Thank you, Kent. We'll see you next time right here on 5 Points Blue.
This has been a production of 5 Points Blue, DallasCowboys.com, and the Dallas Cowboys Football Club.
How about you, Cowboys? Yeah!